Hi, I'm David Marquis, and I'm a Senior Product Manager at Equinix. In this video, I'm going to introduce you to the new Equinix integration with Alibaba Express Connect for Fabric 2022.3. This new integration leverages a new set of Alibaba Partner APIs to create physical connections for customers. Alibaba has updated their connection creation process by having customers accept an Equinix Fabric-created physical connection and subsequently associating a virtual border router, or VBR, to that physical connection. Alibaba has also updated the billing model for these customer connections, as well as introduced outbound data transfer fees for customers. You can refer to the Alibaba Express Connect documentation for more details. Let's jump into the demonstration. So first, log into Equinix Fabric. Once you're in, click Connections, and then Create Connections. Under Frequent Connections, select Alibaba Cloud, and finally, create connection under the Alibaba Cloud Express Connect service profile. Review the steps to create a connection. First, you will need your Alibaba account information, which can be found by logging into the Alibaba Cloud console and hovering over the user icon at the top right of the bar. Second, you will create the connection through Fabric. And finally, you will accept and pay for the connection on the Alibaba Cloud console. Let's go ahead and create the connection. Under Origin, select the port option. Then select the location that you wish to connect from. You can then select the A-side Fabric port from the available list of ports at that location. Under Destination, you can select the location at which you wish to connect to Alibaba. Click on Next. Next, you will provide the connection name. Subsequently, you can then provide the VLAN ID for the A-side port. Next, you will provide the Alibaba account ID that will be used to create the Express Connect physical connection. Lastly, you will select the bandwidth or billing tier for that connection. Then you can go ahead and click on Next. On the final step, you can review the details of the connection summary, and you can also add any additional email addresses for users to receive notifications about this connection. Next, you can click on Submit Order. Once your order is submitted, you can navigate to the Alibaba Cloud Console directly from Fabric for the final step in the process. This will allow you to approve and accept and ultimately pay for that connection on the Alibaba Cloud Console. Alternatively, you can also review the status of your connection on Fabric. Let's go ahead and check out what it looks like on the Fabric inventory. On Fabric, your recently created connection will have a provider status equal to pending approval. This is because the connection needs to be accepted and paid for on the Alibaba Cloud Console. At this point, the connection can be deleted if desired. Let's go ahead and accept the connection on the Alibaba Cloud Console. Once you're on the Alibaba Cloud Console, you can navigate to Express Connect for your account. Under the Physical Connection tab or context, you should be able to see the connection that was just created in Fabric. You should be able to see the name and the bandwidth that was provided during the creation of the connection on Fabric. This should be reflected on the Alibaba Cloud Console. You will also notice that the connection status is down and pending acceptance. Click on Accept and Pay. If your account has not previously enabled outbound data transfer billing, you will first have to accept these billing changes before you can accept the connection. Once these are enabled and accepted, you will be able to proceed with accepting your connection. Confirm the acceptance. Next, you will be directed to a payment page where you can review a few details on the connection and select the duration for the Express Connect on Alibaba. We recommend auto-renewing your subscription as the connection is deprovisioned on Fabric if it is deleted by Alibaba due to unpaid charges. In my case, I'll leave this as is since it is an example connection. Next, you can click on Buy Now. You can further review your order details and ultimately accept the Alibaba Express Connect service agreement. Once you complete that review, you can go ahead and pay. If your Alibaba account does not have a payment method associated to it, you can add one during this final step. Otherwise, you can conclude by clicking Purchase. Once the order has been successfully submitted, you can return to the Express Connect console to review the status of your recently accepted connection. Let's go ahead and refresh the console. At this point, the physical connection should reflect the status up and enabled. Similarly, on Fabric, the connection should be fully provisioned. Let's go ahead and check out what the connection looks like on the Fabric side. At this point, we can see the connection is fully provisioned on Equinix Fabric. The final step that is now required to connect your devices on Fabric with the Alibaba Cloud is the creation of a virtual border router, or VBR, on Alibaba. Let's go ahead and check out what that looks like on the Alibaba console. Under Physical Connections, you can select the connection you just created. You can click on Create VBR. It will ask you to provide a name for this virtual border router. You can then select from the available shared physical connections. In our case, we'll select from the connection we just created on Fabric. It will allow you to review the Z-side VLAN IDs and the bandwidth for that connection. And you'd have to provide the IPv4 address of the Alibaba Cloud Gateway. Next, you can provide the IPv4 address for your device or your data center gateway on Fabric. Finally, provide the subnet mask for the subnet. Lastly, you can confirm your choices and click OK. Once this is complete, your assets on Equinix will be able to communicate with the Alibaba Cloud VBR and any other devices on the Alibaba Cloud. Finally, to deprovision your connection from Fabric, you will have to delete the VBR that was associated with the shared connection. Let's look at what that looks like. Let's assume we want to delete the connection. We would navigate to Actions and click on Delete. Next, we would navigate to the Fabric console, and we should be able to delete that connection from Fabric. This will deprovision the connection and ultimately delete the physical connection from Alibaba. This completes the demonstration, so thank you for watching.